Hi everyone, Father Sam here. I've been thinking with all this social distancing, there's got to be something more that we can do. So we have this YouTube channel. Honestly, I'd forgotten that we had this YouTube channel as a parish. Like and subscribe, okay? If you subscribe to it, the more people we get subscribed to it, the more likely it is that we'll be able to use YouTube Live. That's another service that they have. So if we can do YouTube Live, we might be able to actually reach more of our parishioners, especially those folks who aren't on Facebook. It's great that we're able to do Facebook Live videos, but we're kind of limited with Facebook Live in terms of how many people we might reach, at least in a live setting. So like and subscribe to our St. Pius X Catholic Church YouTube channel. You can click on it down below. I can't believe I'm doing this. I never thought I'd have to do this kind of stuff. I never thought that this was gonna be part of my life. But here it is, all right? I can't be with you guys. I can't be face to face with you. I can't have you coming here to hang out and do things. And I really wish that I could. I wish the circumstances were different, but they're not. This is what we have to do. All right, so we're gonna do this. I am discovering in all of this how much I need a schedule. With my days relatively free, it's really easy to like sit down and waste time. It's really easy to just scroll through Facebook all day long. It's really easy to sit down and turn on the TV and just watch shows or something like that. No, I can't do that. I can't deal with that. I need something more. So I'm discovering the need for a real structured prayer life. I already have some structure to my prayer life, but ordinarily in between my times for prayer and everything each day, there's meetings, there's people, there's ministry, there's stuff that I have to do. Now I don't have any of that, so I'm discovering how much I need to schedule that prayer time and how much I need to find other ways to use my ordinarily ministry time for something else. So I want to encourage you to do the same thing. You guys have work. Many of you are working from home. Many of you are studying at home. You're taking your classes at home. Some of you are teaching your kids from home. Whatever it is that you're doing, number one, I want you to know I'm with you. I'm with you. So let's make a schedule for ourselves. And I want to encourage you in that schedule to include not just your class time or your work time, but include also schedule time for prayer. Every morning on Facebook, we will live stream our 8:30 daily mass. Monday through Saturday, 8:30 in the morning, you're going to find our daily mass. Father Tim and I have been talking also, and we'll make an announcement about this later on, about streaming a second mass. Since each of us has to say mass each day anyway, we figure we might as well offer a second mass each day as well. So there will be another time, probably around lunchtime, so you can do a little lunch break mass with us. Then I want to invite you at 5 o'clock every day, join me for praying the rosary. And I want to encourage us to do that as a family, as a parish family, as individual families. Let's get together. We'll pray the rosary at 5 o'clock each day. I'll live stream that also on Facebook. And that'll just be an opportunity for us to close the workday. If you're still doing schoolwork by 5 o'clock, then we need to have a conversation with your teachers. Kids are going to love me for that. Teachers are going to be upset. Anyway, whatever. 5 o'clock, let's stop and pray. And let's dedicate ourselves to meditating on the mysteries of the rosary, to asking the Blessed Mother's intercession, to praying in particular for an end to this coronavirus and for those who are working in healthcare and working in science to find a cure and to figure out what exactly is happening with this disease. So I want to encourage you to join me 5 o'clock each day to pray the rosary. Then as you make this schedule, as you do it, share your ideas. Post on our Facebook page, post on our Instagram. Tell us what you're doing to keep a schedule and to keep yourself sane. So time for work, time for prayer, time for study, time for recreation. Make sure your time for recreation isn't just on a screen. I know I'm telling you that through a screen, so it's a little weird, but make sure that your time for recreation includes like reading. Include simply being together as a family. Play board games, do puzzles, like do something that doesn't involve technology the entire time. Technology is a great tool. It's a wonderful thing for us to be able to use. But I want to encourage you, go a little further, do a little more, schedule your time well. And in this time, we're going to find that we have a chance to reconnect with one another. We have a chance to reconnect with God. We have a chance to reconnect with our humanity. We have a chance to reprioritize our lives so that we can grow, so that we can be healthy, so that we can live the way that the good Lord intends us to live. So just some encouragement. I look forward to praying with you each day. And if you like and subscribe to this Facebook channel, maybe we can start Facebook channel, YouTube channel. It's a YouTube channel. I can't keep anything straight. All right. Like and subscribe to this YouTube channel, and then we might be able to start offering some YouTube live feeds as well. I'm going to learn a whole ton about different means of social communication. It's not what I thought my life would be. It's not what I thought the priesthood would be. But here it is. We're going to do what it takes. We're going to do what's necessary so that we can continue to growing together in faith, so that we can stay together, so that we can stay united in prayer, in faith, in friendship, as a family. God bless you.